from a good spot. As Thompson walks the line, works it over for Palmieri. Below the goal line, Barzell. Looking over his options, connects to Nelson. Thompson, one-timer, rebound there. Barzell couldn't get it back on net.
Great pass from Brock Nelson to Engvall, and couldn't find the corner or couldn't elevate it. It came pretty quick, pretty hard. But what an opportunity that was.
Islanders coming again. Nelson in, shoot, scores! Oh, you've seen that one a time or two. Nelson's got his second.
Tremendous transition, Brendan. I mean, the Islanders came up, had a nice 3-on-2. Hit him on the left side, so Islanders getting up in a hurry. Good pass, Ryan Pollock. There's Palmieri through the middle, drive through. And Brock Nelson, he just does it. This from there, he knows where he wants to go, and he can put it there. He's a sharpshooter, just whistles that one past the goaltender. Well, they had a couple of good opportunities, and this line continues to have terrific chemistry. I don't know if that was a planned play or not, but it worked out pretty well. Look out.
Here's Hughes in alone, trying to settle it, and it's Sorokin who comes up with the answer. Oh, wow. From the Islander goaltender. Watch it again. Former Islander Travis Green now in charge of this Devils power play. As Timo Meier comes in and curls away from Aho, sets up Hamilton, and he scores. Dougie Hamilton with a heavy one-timer that gets through Sorokin, and the Devils tie in on the power play.
Yeah, just a great, great play. Talk about teeing the puck up. Watch in the middle of your screen. There's Hamilton, a right-hander. Meier looks him up, and it just wires that thing. And I talked about Sorokin being able to get set. No chance to get set there. He was on his way out. Five hole, I believe that. I like to have been in the dressing room between that period because I'm sure Lane Lambert had plenty to say. That was the worst period of hockey the Islanders had played, as far as I'm concerned. And mind you, they haven't played many, seven periods, but that was not a very good period for them.
They have the ultimate equalizer in net in Ilya Sorokin, which is the reason it's a 1-1 score. Could have been 3-4-1 perhaps, as Hughes carries in now to Foley. To Foley, wait, shoot, scores! That one ramped up off the stick of Adam Pellick and jumped over the shoulder of Sorokin. A power play goal just 21 seconds into the period. Tyler Toffoli's first goal as a Devil.
And look at the speed through the neutral zone, cross-ice passes. Islanders almost get it down. And then the quick pass to Hughes, and he's able to get it. The quick passes, and then Toffoli with a great wrist shot. I mean, he's found a home there. I guess why wouldn't you? You mentioned it, Brendan, right off the stick. It looks to me of Adam Pelican right over the shoulder. So, you know, he's fairly motivated this year. Yeah, Casey likes to contribute, and not only from a checking standpoint, but offensively. Had that one, 20 goal season.
Yeah. And finished last year with none in his last 27. Here's Nelson alone. Scores! Happy Brocktober to all who celebrate. Nelson's got a pair tonight.
Islanders win that draw. They're going to go down around the boards with it, and again, good hard work along the boards. Here's the turnover, and Brock slides into the slot. Look at the patience, and then he just waits, gets his head up, and says, okay, what's open? Watch him lift his head, takes a little look, says, okay, I got a five hole there. I can see him spreading his legs. That is a gifted goal scorer.
Hughes to Hughes to Toffoli. Luke Hughes plays it now for Pratt. They quickly find 86 in Jack Hughes. Luke Hughes winds up and shoots and scores. All the attention on Jack Hughes. It's his little brother Luke who finds the back of the net. The third power play goal tonight for New Jersey.
That's Hughes on your left as he comes around, and then his brother right in the area. So let's just see if that's... Oh, Sorokin was screened. He was looking left and didn't have a chance to really pick that one up. You can see...
No chance.
Yeah, that's Brad in front of the net, and Cizikas goes down, and that's just a perfect shot.
Martin for Clutterbuck. Too hot to handle.
Yeah, that was a good pass by Martin to Clutter, and Clutter just said, bounced off his stick a little bit, but good try.
Martin feeds Dobson down low, and they score! Dobson with a good look to Horvat along the goal line. Tough angle, no problem, tied at 3.
Yeah, really sharpshooter. Good play by Noah Dobson. Defender Once Matty Martin gets the puck, hangs on to it, takes a little look. Here comes Noah Dobson moving in. And the fake. And boy, there just wasn't any room there. Well, I guess there was. Beautiful shot by Horvat as he just off the pad and in. Good Karen, no hesitation. And Bo needed that one badly. That'll help him.
This one out for Siegenthaler. Goes wide of the net. Picked up by Bastion. Bastion angles it to Hamilton. Across the ice, Siegenthaler. Snaps one tip down, rebound, it's Sorokin! Another sensational save!
Well, Siegenthaler gets this thing right towards the net, and look at Bastion, and there's a sliding across, pad down, flat. I mean, talk about the ability to be able to flex those legs, and he just makes that save. He even had the glove up a little higher, just in case he needed to use the glove, but he's got it in position, got the leg. Schmidt at the other end hasn't been anywhere near as busy, so the Islanders will probably be looking to put a little more pressure on the goaltender at the Devil's End.
But at the same time, when Barry Trotz was coaching the Capitals, it's been that long. Mr. Ovechkin certainly had something to do with it.
I'm sure he did.
Pass in front, and they score again. It's Jack Hughes on the power play. Four power play goals for New Jersey as they take the lead here in the third. That one took 28 seconds to find the back of the net.
You watch the bottom of your screen where Ryan Pollock is. They're going to look. Watch Pollock. He's going to look for it. They're going to go back and forth, and Hughes just comes sliding right in. And I'm not sure about the position there, whether that's Cizikas or, of course, Ryan Pollock. But you've got to know where your guys are. And that goes right through the crease.
And there's no doubt to me, but
1:20 to go. Empty net for New York. Extra attacker on, trying to tie the score. Palmieri shoots. Save Schmid. Rebound. Schmid. It's in.
Yelling for that puck the second it got over the blue line. We'll take another look at it, but he wanted this puck and he went and found it.
That's Barzal, a little slide over to Palmieri, and he just gets it towards the net. Little rebound off the glove, and there, follow it right up. A fortuitous bounce, but everybody at the net. Anders Lee and the Islanders finally get a break.
The Devils were yelling at the officials, saying that should have been a hand pass by Matt Barzal. We've taken a couple looks at it. That would be a tough challenge. That has tied this score. Each team with a goal here in the third period. Devils got one early. Islanders get one late. Two goals for Nelson. Two goals for Horvat. 32 saves for Sorokin. And we are not done yet. The Islanders' first overtime game of this young season. Nelson, Pellick, and Palmieri on the ice against Jack Hughes, Luke Hughes, and Jesper Bratt.
And McLeod was just out for the faceoff, and Brock Nelson won the faceoff. So, and then McLeod went off right away.
Palmieri drops Nelson, had it poked away. Two on one up the ice as Nelson tries to hustle back. Jack Hughes in, shoots, save! Sorokin! Marino out high, and it comes to center. Marino chased back into his own end. Sets it up for Jack Hughes. Fresh onto the ice. Jack Hughes waiting for Luke. It's Hughes. He scores! Jack Hughes does it himself. A 5-4 overtime win for the Devils.
The Islanders just gave him way too much room. They had an opportunity to close him down right away. And terrific shot by Hughes as he went to the forehand and beat Sorokin.